My name is Delano Crowfield. I'm 30 years old, and I have a large lipoma on my shoulder blade. When I was 19, I noticed I had a pain in my shoulder, and I looked in the mirror, and there was a small knot about that big. I thought I overdid myself, like I pulled a muscle or something. My life kind of changed from then. As it was getting bigger, I noticed my self-esteem dropping. So one day, I picked up a shirt and I put it over my shoulder. And at first, it was small enough for me to hide it, you know? And then as it got bigger and bigger, it wasn't hideable no more, but this shirt has always been my security blanket. I went to the doctor for it. I thought he was going to remove it, but he just drained it for me. Like a month and a half after he drained it, it started coming back. After that, I kind of lost faith in doctors. I'm interested in working here. You mind if I get an application?
Thank you, motherfucker.
Most jobs is not going to let you wear this shirt on your shoulder or whatever. So when I have to take that shirt off, that's when they notice it. The people that's hiring me, they're nice. They make it seem like I'm going to get the job, and then I never hear from them again. That's hard, me not being able to provide for myself to the point where I was sleeping outside at bus stops. And
he called me and told me that he was sleeping on a park bench, and I said, hey, why not come here, you know?
During this last time where I was homeless, Ariana, you asked your mom, can I come over and stay the night? Miss Armstrong, you want some chips?
Yeah, a little, thank you.
A little?
She let me come over and accepted me in her home.
There you go. I'll put you some chips on there, too.
Thank you. He showed me so much kindness. I'm hoping that after this surgery, he will be able to hold his head up high and to know I am somebody.
With this surgery, I hope the fire that used to burn in me when I was younger before this came, I feel like I'm going to spark that again. Not even the sky's the limit, you know? It's no limit to what I can do. I'm kind of nervous. I'm not really scared. I'm just nervous about it going right.
How are you? Delano, is that right?
Yes.
Hi, I'm Dr. Lee.
Nice to meet you.
Really nice to meet you.
Finally.
So tell me what's going on. What brought you from Houston?
I have a large lump on my shoulder.
Okay.
Right here.
Well, let me take a look at it if you don't mind, okay?
Okay.
Okay, let's see.
You want me to take my shirt off?
I think that would be the easiest. Yeah, I do. If you don't mind?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, hold on. I'll just pull up over you. Okay, and I'm going to put your shoulders. Yeah, like there you go. Yeah, now, was this removed partially? Before I see a little scar line there.
It was drained last year.
It was drained?
Drained.
What do you mean by drained? Is there fluid in there?
Yeah, there's like fluid, nothing but fluid. And
so the whole thing flattened?
Yeah, flattened.
What did they say it was?
They said it was a lipoma or whatever.
But a lipoma, you can't drain it. I mean, a lipoma.
Yeah, I feel like he was experimenting.
And so how quickly did it reform?
A month and a half.
So when you tell me the story, it does make me wonder what this is. It just kind of throws me for a loop, really.
Yeah.
Delano's is easily one of the most interesting cases I've ever seen. His story does not completely make sense to me. He says that the area is drained, yet he has an excision line with suture marks there. That's an excision, where you're trying to excise a mass, not drain a liquid. It makes me think, okay, let me just reassess this and make sure that we're looking at all different possibilities here before I proceed. He didn't tell you what it was that drained out? Okay.
You know, I kind of was, like, disappointed.
So I numbed the surface of your skin, and so I'm just gonna see if I can pull out any fluid from there, okay?
You never really hear about people having something on them that doctors don't know what it is, you know? So it's scary.
You all right?
Yeah.
We have fluid in there, you're exactly right. this is definitely not a lipoma. I don't know why it's there. I don't know why it's collecting. There's obviously something that is leaking and getting trapped in the subcutaneous spaces and creating this growth there.
She kept filling up tubes of it. I can actually hear it inside of my head. I felt like the fluid wasn't going to stop. Like she was just going to have to keep filling up tube after tube after tube.
Something kind of triggered the fluid to escape from where it's supposed to be, and now it's in this space. The thing is that you have to seal it somehow. So I can really drain it, though, and make it really nice and flat, but there's a chance that this can come back.
Here we go again.
This is exactly what I feared.
It seemed like nobody can help me.
Let's try to get this nice and flat as we can, and let's try to get that follow-up this time. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
As I'm filling up all these syringes of straw-colored fluid, I know that this fluid is coming from somewhere. And I'm trying to get all the fluid out as I can to make it flat, but I think it's coming back.
7, 3, 8, 2, 9, 32, 1, 32, 33.
So almost a liter. Look at that. I do not know what this yellowish fluid is. I'm gonna send some of it into the labs and make some phone calls and see if we can't figure out what's going on here, okay? So I got some work to do.
I do feel better that she took the pressure off. I still got a little worry in me, like if they're gonna be able to fix it or how fast it's gonna come back. So I'm a little worried about that.
I have to make sure that Delano doesn't get discouraged by this. This is gonna be a longer road. It's gonna take us some time to figure this out, but he has some wonderful improvement. He's gonna feel good. He's not gonna have any more pain. He better know that I'm in this with him. We're in this together.
Dr. Lee has been checking up on me at least once a week. Last week, she told me she wanted me to come back to LA and get a CT scan done. I'm nervous about what she's going to say. You know, the fluid can be cancerous if it's attached to my spine. My life can get a lot better today, and it could also get a lot worse today. Depends on what Dr. Lee tells me.
I was wondering if you don't mind if I take a look at it and see how it looks now? Okay. Here, let me pull this out too. There we go. It's about maybe one-third the size it was. The most important step for us was to do the CT scan, because what a CT scan does is it essentially like takes slices of you and takes a picture of it. Uh-huh. So as if you were cut like a loaf of bread,
right.
And then we can track where this fluid is and kind of see where the origin
right.
of this is. So I have the results.
All right.
So this is when they slice it like this, okay? Mm-hmm. This way.
Mm-hmm.
So this is that fluid mass right here.
We have in our body something called the lymphatic system. It's essentially a system of tubes or vessels in our body. So imagine it's like a lot like a garden hose. For whatever reason, in Delano's neck, he has a blockage of his lymphatic vessels. And so now that there's a block or a kink in this garden hose, there is a natural backup of fluid behind it. So what's happening is it's found a space right under his skin on his upper back. A surgeon needs to go into his neck area and really remove this kink in his lymphatic system.
This is called a lymphangioma. The really good news with that is it is benign, okay? It is nothing to worry about in terms of life-threatening by any means. Yes. I'm so happy to tell you that.
That makes me feel really good. I feel great, for real. It felt good to know that she knew what it was. Like, it was such a big relief, for real.
What we're gonna do is we're gonna find somebody that's gonna be able to help you.
We're gonna find him a great surgeon who's gonna take care of that area permanently for him.
That's
I
a
really
deeper kind
you.
Of, of course. You know that I got your back, right? I literally got your back here, too.
Dr. Lee has really boosted my self-esteem back up and made me ready to face the world again. I feel really good about my future.